Serious hazards near the freeway ended up leading to a deadly crash in East El Paso. An investigative report obtained by the ABC 7 I team shows several safety deficiencies at a construction site are linked to a double fatal crash on Interstate 10 back in 2017.
We brought you the first part of this investigation in February when we uncovered 9 calls were made to 911 over an hour's time, warning of a piece of construction equipment hanging over a driving lane on I-10 East. A young couple driving an 18-wheeler slammed into it and lost their lives.
Tonight, ABC 7's Stephanie Valle continues our investigation. It's a story you'll see only on ABC 7.
This is the 6-page report that the Occupational Safety and Health Administration, or OSHA, provided to ABC 7 after we filed a request under the Freedom of Information Act. The report shows investigators found several flaws at a construction site, but OSHA says it has no jurisdiction and doesn't plan to do anything about it.
Oh my God!
That's a 911 operator. What is the
emergency? Okay, somebody's hurt now, really.
What's the address of the emergency?
The crash was first reported around 2:40 a.m. on December 21st, 2017. Investigators say 24-year-old Patrick Van Fossen slammed the semi-truck he was driving into this piece of construction equipment that was sticking 4 feet out onto the highway. The impact of the collision ripped through the cabin where his 22-year-old fiancée, Caseri Paredes, was sleeping. Both were killed. We are now learning never before disclosed information about the construction site where the cement placer was located. The OSHA report indicates Jar Construction, the local company contracted by the Texas Department of Transportation to work on that section of I-10, did not correctly identify safety hazards. OSHA found access to the construction site was not restricted and the keys were not removed from the ignition of the concrete placer when workers left the job site at about 4:30 that afternoon.
The construction site was right here at I-10 East and Americas. OSHA also found that if the keys weren't left in the ignition, the engine wouldn't be able to turn on and the conveyor belt wouldn't have lifted. According to the report, a Jar supervisor told an OSHA investigator the concrete placer had one key and it was always left in the ignition. It is illegal in the state of Texas to leave keys in the ignition of a vehicle.
OSHA determined, quote, there were hazards observed that could have prevented the conveyor from the concrete placer to be overhanging in the interstate, end quote. Jar Construction was established more than 60 years ago, according to its website. It says, quote, our employees take pride in their quality of work and are committed to surpassing deadlines and recognize that excellence in performance is the key to success. But throughout its inspection, OSHA noted Jar Construction did not act in good faith, delaying the investigation continuously. I went to the Jar office in the Lower Valley to ask management for a comment. I have not received a response.
My name is Stephanie Vian.
I also contacted Jar's attorney in this case and have not received a call back.
Since February, Jar has declined to comment on this story. According to the assistant director of El Paso's OSHA office, the agency cannot issue citations because it doesn't have jurisdiction over semi-truck accidents that happen on the interstate. So ABC 7 will continue to investigate who has jurisdiction and whether that agency will conduct the investigation necessary to hold anybody accountable. So ultimately, your commute on the freeway becomes safer. Stephanie Valle, ABC 7.
And ABC 7 has contacted numerous agencies at the local, state, and federal level. The results of that investigation coming up on Tuesday and Wednesday at 10, only on ABC 7.